that will bear my mind and will see it as it is. Majority, because of want of favor and benefits, they might not be able to say certain things. It is our duty as leaders to be held accountable to our promises, electoral promises. It is our duty as leaders to be consistent. It should be consistent. Whatever we say yesterday should be able to match what is happening today. What I said about the president is very clear. I said that the president, at the point before this visit, was incapacitated and has been on a life support. I stand by it. I have no regret for that statement. You recall that I said the president, handlers of the president, should produce evidence to the contrary within 48 hours. Barely after 4 weeks, they said they went to visit the president. Thank God the president is getting better. But there's no denial. There's no denying that what I said at the time was the truth. If you go by the statement of the governor of Ebonyi, he said the president's recovery is a miracle, is divine, which means something has gone the other way around before becoming a miracle. You understand? I read in another piece, somebody said the president came up like Lazarus from the dead. Well, that is another person saying that. All I'm saying is that I stand by what I've said, not in the wish that the president must die, but don't forget, more importantly, the president owes it to us all to declare his state of health. The president's life should be an open book that should be read by everybody. That when you look at Senator McKay, he said, I have brain tumor. That doesn't make him any less, but he's being honest to the people of America, the people that elected him. Aside this, aside the president's ailment, the fact remains is that the president is not strong again. When you see the pictures, they are frail. The president is frail. It's not a must that we must hold on to power, even when we don't have the strength. Like I said, I have nothing against the president. Nigeria is more important. Nigeria is a country that needs help at this time. Nigeria is a country that needs all hands on to be able to get a better tomorrow, to have our economy fixed, to have things change in our favor. As it is, the president can equally come back and go home to rest. He needs all the rest. As it is now, the president has spent more time abroad, outside the country, than on his table, on his seat, in the villa. It's not okay. That does not mean we won't want him dead, but we want the best for Nigerians. Life, the life of Nigerians is more important than the life of an individual. If I'm not well, Ekiti still has to move forward. You understand? So my advice is that the president should get well. We're praying for him, but he should have, he has to take this position, he has to take a decision whether to tag on, whether to be a visiting president, whether to be a president in diaspora, whether to be a president that is taking care of Nigerians in the UK. One decision has to be taken. I love him, but I'm saying that the president should take a back seat. Visiting the president in London, going so many times to justify. One good thing you will not take away is that this position of mine over time has equally put these people on the spot to equally bring forth the president, to bring the president to the fore. Otherwise, we were hearing nothing about the president since he left. Everybody was prevented. We were prevented from knowing what was going on. So it was because I of a few things that I said, they want to do damage control. They want to at least do something to make sure that they defend or they showcase the president. I wish him well, but I tell you very expressly, health is wealth. Without strength, you can't do much. If the president wants to be honorable, it's still the best for the president to allow this country to move forward. Because if you say the president, we should wait for when the doctor will ask him to come home. So if the president will be coming home a day to the expiration of his tenure, we should still wait. Then we'll keep waiting. The Lord God will deliver Nigeria.